Good morning students, how are you? I hope you all are doing fine. Students, today I am going to teach history, the new chapter, chapter 2, Early Humans. In this chapter, we will study about introduction of the early humans, Stone Age and division of Stone Age, Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic. So in this chapter we are going to study about Paleolithic and Mesolithic. Let us start the class. Students, in early days human life was very hard. They spent their life in caves, wrap animal skin and tree leaves over their body and hunt animals for food. In modern times, humans do not live in caves. Today we are living a better life in concrete flats and facilitated with TV, video, schools and colleges, have variety of nutritional foods and better means of communication and transportation. But can you imagine a life without such facilities for us? A life where there is no big society, no house to live, no good food, no clothes to wear, etc. How does it feel to listen? Yes, we are talking about the wildlife. And this was the life of none other than our ancestors. Here, ancestors, who is that early man who used to live in jungle and lived a very hard life. According to scientists, life began on the earth some 3500 million years ago. Human life has evolved over millions of years. Subsequently, human beings developed in stages over millions of years till they reached the most advanced stage of development. Here, first you have to understand what is evolution. The modern human represents the most advanced stage in the process of development called evolution. Here, the modern human. Who is modern humans? Modern human beings are called Homo sapiens. Who is Homo sapiens? Modern human beings. A person who can think are called Homo sapiens. So we are all Homo sapiens. So all human living on earth are today are called Homo sapiens. The modern Homo humans represent the most advanced stage in the process of development are called evolution. So what is evolution? A series of slow changes in a living thing from which it develops to its current stage over a long period of time is called evolution. For example, from your childhood, how you were there. So from your childhood to till now, how much process of development you had. Then still your process of development will be there when you will reach the most advanced stage in the process of development called evolution. So the whatever you, from your childhood to till now, your process of development over a long period of time, that is called evolution. So early human beings, their advanced stage, so their stages, their process of development stage, when they will reach the advanced stage, it is called evolution. Is it clear, student, what is evolution? The modern human represents the most advanced stage in the process of development is called evolution. Is it clear? Students, look at the image of different stages of human evolutions. Already we have discussed what is evolution. In the initial stages of development, humans walk like apes. Here, what is apes? Apes a type of animal like a large monkey with no tail or only a few short tail. No tail at all, otherwise very little short tail will be there. Chimpanzees and gorillas are apes. So, first humans, early humans walk like apes. Look at that first image. Early humans walk like apes. Gradually they learn to stand on their feet with a straight posture. Their hands became free, which helped them to hold things better. They could pick up and throw things to defend themselves. The body structure of the earliest human beings changed over time. So in this picture you can see first that early humans walk like apes. Gradually they learn to stand on their feet with their straight posture. Their all hands are free. So when their hands are free, then only they can able to help them to hold things better, and they could defend themselves. Throw things, pick up to defend themselves. The body structure of the early humans changed overall over a long period of time. Their entire body structure will be changes. Their brain became larger, while the jaws and teeth got reduced in size. Brain also became larger than their jaws and teeth. Earlier it is very very big size. They learned to adapt themselves to their surroundings. How to adapt? So how they learn how to adapt themselves to their surroundings in this process. So these different stages of human evolution's process was occurred in the early period. So in this process only they learn to use stones to kill the prey, for crunching nuts and so on. Is it clear, students? In the different stages of human evolutions, they learned, early humans learned to adapt themselves to their surroundings. In this process they learned to use stones to kill prey, for crunching nuts and so on. They realized, early human realized that sharp edges of broken stones very useful for cutting wood and spiking animals. Further, they learned to use stones for making tools and weapons according to their needs. Let us see Stone Age. What is Stone Age? The prehistoric age is also known as Stone Age. So the prehistoric period when weapons and tools were made up of stone. In this Stone Age period only, stones were used on a large scale. In the prehistoric age or period, then mainly tools, weapons and implements made of stones were used. That period known as Stone Age. The Stone Age period is divided into four periods. Look at these pictures. One is Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic, Chalcolithic. Paleolithic, 2 million to 12,000 years, 2 million years ago, and ended in about 12,000 years ago. Mesolithic, around 12,000 to 10,000 years ago. Neolithic, around 6,000 to 4,000 years ago. Chalcolithic, around 4,000 to 1,700 years ago. First, we will see the Paleolithic age. Explain the term Paleolithic age. The word Paleolithic has come from two Greek words. One is Paleo and Lithos. The word Paleolithic is derived from two Greek language words. One is Paleo and Lithic. The literary meaning of Paleo is old. Old one. The literary meaning of Lithic is stone. In short, we can say that the term Paleolithic stands for Old Stone Age or the earliest Stone Age. Once again, I will repeat, explain the term Paleolithic age. The word Paleolithic is derived from two Greek language words. One is paleo and lithic. The literary meaning of paleo is old. Old one, the literary meaning of lithic is stone. So in short, we can say that the term Paleolithic age stands for old stone age or the earliest stone age. The name itself shows the importance of stone tools and implements. Next, certain environmental changes started taking place about 12,000 years ago. This period, this marks the beginning of the Mesolithic or Middle Stone Age. Look at the second one, Mesolithic or Middle Stone Age. The term meso means middle in Greek. The term meso means middle in Greek. This period marked a phase of transition between the Paleolithic and Neolithic ages. So the Mesolithic period, this Mesolithic period marked a phase of transition between the Paleolithic and the Neolithic ages. It was followed by Neolithic and Chalcolithic ages, which were far more advanced than the preceding ages in terms of technology and methods of tool making, as well as different aspects of life. So in this chapter, we will study about Paleolithic age and Mesolithic age. We shall read about them in the next chapter, Neolithic and Chalcolithic. Is it clear, students? Students, today we have learned about how the early humans evolved through different stages of psychological and mental development. And early humans learned to use stones for making tools and weapons according to their needs. Then what is Stone Age? The prehistoric age is known as Stone Age because stones were used on this period large scale. And division of Stone Age. Stone Age is divided into four periods. One is Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic and Chalcolithic. That's all for today class. I hope you all understood. Meet you in the next class. Till then, revise the chapter. Talk. Thank you. Have a nice day.